Namaste to everyone, myself Rohini Mirgu, talking about relation between the coordinate systems. Learning outcomes. At the end of this video, you will be able to determine the relationship between cylindrical and Cartesian coordinates and vice versa. You will be able to determine the relationship between spherical and Cartesian coordinates and vice versa. Before we move further, as we are finding out the relation between the coordinate system, let us list the types of coordinate system and its coordinates. Types of coordinate systems are Cartesian or rectangular coordinate system, XYZ, cylindrical coordinate system, rho phi z, spherical coordinate system, r theta phi. So just revise the cylindrical coordinate system, which is rho phi z. It consists of two planes, phi constant plane and z constant plane. The phi constant plane is shown in yellow, z constant plane, the one which is shown in purple color, violet color, and one cylinder, which is rho constant cylinder, is shown here in pink one, the cylinder. So this is cylindrical coordinate system. And if I want to find the relation between the cylindrical and Cartesian coordinate system, let me just repeat. Cylindrical coordinates are rho, phi, z. Cartesian coordinates are x, y, and z. So I want to find the cylindrical to Cartesian conversion. That means I know rho, phi, z. I want x, y, z. So here a piece of a cylinder is shown. This is a small piece of a cylinder having radius rho, angle 5. Angle is phi and the length is z. And also I can see this rho. Now I want to find xyz. That means if this point P is here, if I draw perpendicular on x-axis, this is x-axis, isn't it? So if I draw perpendicular on x-axis, what is this distance? So the same is projected upward. If I draw perpendicular from this point P onto the y-axis, what is this distance? So that we are trying to find out. So can you see here, this is phi. So this angle also goes to be phi. If this angle is phi and this radius is rho, this front side will be rho sine phi, right? As this is rho sine phi, this is parallel line. A parallel line on the opposite side is rho sine phi. And this rho sine phi, when projected downwards, is nothing but the y-axis. So I can say that y is nothing but rho sine phi. Similarly, I can see here the adjacent side. This is rho, the angle is phi. The adjacent side is rho cos phi. The same length, if projected downward, it is nothing but x-axis. So I can say that x is rho cos phi. And z is as it is. Z in cylindrical and Cartesian will remain same. So x is rho cos phi, y is rho sin phi, and z is z. If I want to move reverse, what I mean is, if I want that the cylindrical coordinates from the Cartesian. Cartesian is known to me and I want to find cylindrical. So for that, just recall whatever relation that just now we have written. X is rho cos phi, y is rho sin phi, z is z. Now, if I want rho, rho is available in these two equations only. So what I'll do is, I'll square and add these two. So that sin phi and cos phi will go away, because sin square phi plus cos square phi is 1. So when I square and add these two, x square plus y square is equal to rho cos phi square plus rho sin phi square. So I get it as a rho square inside the bracket, cos square phi plus sin square phi. This is 1. Cos square plus sin square is 1. So I get as x square plus y square is equal to rho square, or rho is equal to under root of x square plus y square. One relation we got for the coordinate, that is rho. Second coordinate let us do for phi. Again, phi is available only in these two. If I divide y by x, I get rho sin phi is y I get rho cos phi as x. So rho gets cancelled out and sine upon cos is nothing but tan phi. So I get y by x is equal to tan phi and phi is tan inverse y by x. So I got rho, I got phi, z is remaining as it is. So the relation Cartesian to cylindrical. So I know Cartesian, I am trying to find out cylindrical. So it is how like this. Rho is equal to under root of x square plus y square. Phi is equal to tan inverse of y by x. Z is equal to z. Now we'll see the relation between Cartesian and spherical. So just revise the spherical coordinate system in which the coordinates are r, theta, phi. Spherical coordinate system consists of one circle, which is r constant circle as shown here, one plane which is phi constant plane as shown in yellow color, one cone which is theta constant cone which is shown here, right? Then the relation between spherical and Cartesian coordinate system can be given like this. Spherical to Cartesian means I know r, theta, phi and I am trying to find out x, y and z. So for that, let us refer this diagram. Here this is x-axis, this is y, this is z. The angle with respect to x-axis is phi. The angle made with z-axis is theta. This is radius r, which is in spherical coordinate system. Now, I want to find out first x. So if this is the point P projected on the x-axis, this distance is x. Point P projected on y-axis, this is y. So if I want to find x, I can find x like whatever this distance, here it is named as rho. So this distance into the front side, into the adjacent side, because x is the adjacent. So this distance into the adjacent side, that means cos phi. So I can say rho cos phi will be my x. But what is this rho? This rho, if I project upward here, you can see this one. This can be given as the front side of the theta and the radius is r. So it is r sine theta. So front side is r sine theta. So this is also r sine theta. So if this is r sine theta, the adjacent side x is r sine theta cos phi. So this is written here, r sine theta cos phi. Then if I want to find y, y is same as like this. It is front side. As it is front side, I can say that this length into sine phi. What is this length? This length is r sine theta. So I can say that y, which is the see this length, which is r sine theta into sine phi. So y is equal to r sine theta sine phi. And if I want to find z, z is this distance, isn't it? So if I want to find z, z is the adjacent side for this angle theta. So I can say that it is r, hypotenuse is r. So it is r cos theta. So r cos theta is z. So spherical to Cartesian relations are x is equal to r sin theta cos phi, y is equal to r sin theta sin phi, z is equal to r cos theta. Now I want to do reverse. That means Cartesian is known to me x, y, z. And I am trying to find out spherical, which is r theta phi. So let us do that. For that, just recall these relations. X is r sin theta cos phi. Y is r sin theta sin phi. Z is r cos theta. Now I try to find out r. So when I try to find out r, r is available in all three. So let us square and add all these three. X square plus y square plus z square. So if I square this, you can see here in these two terms, r square sin theta comes out as a constant. Inside the bracket, cos square phi plus sin square phi plus r cos theta. Again, in these two, this cos square plus sin square going to be 1. And then left out term is r square sin theta plus r square cos square theta. In these two, again, r square is a constant. Inside the bracket, sin square theta plus cos square theta. This term again going to be 1. So I get only this much as my equation. And then I can say r as equal to under root of x square plus y square plus z square. So here the difference to be remembered, In cylindrical coordinate system, rho is under root of x square plus y square only, whereas in spherical coordinate system, the radius r is equal to under root of x square plus y square plus z square. So z square term is added in the radius. One term we have calculated, which is r. Now let us see how to find theta. If I want to find theta, you can see that I can use only this equation is enough to find theta, last equation, that is z r cos theta. Theta is cos inverse of z by r. Now z I keep as it is, r just now we have calculated. So I can say that theta is equal to cos inverse of z upon under root of x square plus y square plus z square. And if I want to find phi, phi is available in these two equations. So I'll take these two equations ratio y by x, which is r sin theta sin phi upon r sin theta cos phi. R sin theta cancels out, sin upon cos goes to be tan, so that I get phi as tan inverse y by x. So second coordinate also we have calculated, third coordinate also we have calculated. So Cartesian to spherical conversion is r is equal to under root of x square plus y square plus z square. Theta is equal to cos inverse of z upon under root of x square plus y square plus z square. Phi is equal to tan inverse y upon x. These are the references used for preparing this video. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.